Hindi tayo magpaala, magte-textan tayo, tatawag lang tayo sa ating girlfriend, sabi natin, ay, may pupunta kami, barkada, aalisa tayo. Why? Because priority natin, barkada natin. But when we get married, our priority changes. We are now one body. Therefore, the way we relate to our barkada is different. So men, I don't know if you've heard this. Tatawag sa iyo kaibigan mo, mag-aaya. Di ba? Mag-aaya. Magkakapi sa labas. Newly married kayo, inaalaw ka. Pero at a certain point, meron tayong maririnig na ganito. Han, love, pwede ba ako ano, nag-aaya sa kumpare, lalabas lang kami sandali. Pwede ba ako sumama? Ito ang sagot, bahala ka. Nakangiti naman, di ba? Napaka-delikado ng salitang yan. Yan katagang yan. Delikado yan. Di ba? Kasi tayo, pag na-misinterpret natin yung word na ikaw na, bahala ka. Di ba? Nakangiti sa'yo. Diba? Dato mo na ibig sabihin niya na either, ikaw, sige, mag-enjoy ka. Pagbalik mo, wala ako, wala na ako. Di ba? O gera na to. Di ba? That means, my friends, it is difficult to relate sometimes with our spouse. But the critical thing is this. If we understand and we reference it with the body of Christ, we will take care of our spouse. In Romans 12:1-2, this is what it says. Therefore, I urge you, brethren, by the mercy of God, to present your bodies a living sacrifice, a living and holy sacrifice, acceptable to God, which is your spiritual service of worship. Now, let me stop in verse 1. We are being called to offer ourselves physically to the Lord. God's desire is for us to be a living sacrifice for Him. When we say we are living sacrifice, we will die to ourselves. Tama ba? Di ba? Because when you're put in the altar of sacrifice, you are killed. Which means here's what Jesus say, what Paul is saying. You lie at the altar of sacrifice and offer yourself to God. And as you offer yourself to God, all your relationships is offered to God. Therefore, whatever kind of person our spouse is, as we are offered to the Lord, we have to find the humility and the love and the decision to love our spouse. Okay? Clear ba tayo? Diba? Therefore, do not be confirmed to the things of this, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind so that you may prove what the will of God is, that which is good and acceptable and perfect. Therefore, there has to be a renewing of the mind. The way we relate to our spouse, it should change. We should see him as somebody who loves us. For though the grace given to me, I say to everyone who will, do not think more highly of himself than he ought to think, but to think so as to have sound judgment, as God has allotted to each a measure of faith. For just as we have many members in one body and one member do not have the same function, so we who are many are one body in Christ and individually one member of another. Now, why am I looking at this?